and she's my Mossy, Mansi Singh.
Hey guys, how are you all?
And she's gonna tell us importance of reading.
And her fluent English.
And I love reading.
Yo, she loves reading and her fluent English is a result of reading. Right, Sanvi?
Yes.
Welcome back to my channel. This is Mansi from Readers and Creators, and you have already met my cute niece Sanvi, and she is seriously a good reader. I won't say avid reader because she's just 6 years old, but she loves to read, and this is not like we are spoiling her childhood fun and all that. She loves to read fairy tales and fables and all that, and on her special demand, I have to make her appear in the video. So yeah, let's talk about what I'm gonna talk about. Okay, so in this video, we're gonna talk about the most annoying question a reader has to face in his or her daily life. Like, what do you get with so much reading? Why do you read so much? It's not getting any exam qualified, or you are not getting any job due to reading. So why do you read? It's a waste of time, right? No, man, no. It makes our life. So yeah, I'm gonna tell you about why we should read and why reading is so important and why we treat books like human beings. Okay, firstly, I will tell you about how reading has impacted me in my life and how books have helped me be a better person. So, I have been reading for more than 8 years, and over this span of time, I have matured a lot. It's not just I have been growing in numbers. Books have helped me to identify things, to have a perspective of my own, to have an opinion of my own about certain things, certain people, and certain characteristics in different personalities. And books have made me compassionate and confident more than ever. Seriously, the confidence thing is the most important things I've got as a gift from books. I'm currently so confident about what I have to say, what I have to wear, what I have to do, and about my choices and everything. I just go out and do what I want. I just say out loud whatever my opinions are, and I don't care about the judgments of hypocrite society. I don't care about what people will think about me, and I choose better for myself. Third and the most important lesson reading gave me is I can be selfless and selfish at the same time. Being selfish is always taken as the most negative thing, and of course it is in some aspects, in more than some aspects, yeah. But being selfish for yourself, like choosing better for yourself, like making decisions for yourself, like putting someone behind who has been holding you back. So, being selfish is not negative, rather necessary. And this is the most important lesson I learned from reading, that I can be selfish and selfless at the same time. Now, why should we read? The most important question. Why? Why should we make a habit of reading? Why should we read daily and just be a nerd, right? Because, first of all, books are lifetime companion. They won't betray you, ever. You have always heard this cliche dialogues in Bollywood films and in certain books too, that books don't demand, neither they complain. So yeah, it's a truest thing. Books are lifetime companion, and whenever you are having a bad day, just pick up your favorite book, sit in a corner of room and start reading. And within next 5 to 6 minutes, you will be part of that story. You will be so in awe with the characters, and you will be into that book that you forget about all the bad things happened in that day. So yeah, they are the best companion. Second is, reading is like de-stressing. Whenever you have a hectic day, and you are just finishing every task you have for the day, and in the night when you get in your bed and hold a book in your hands, it's like the immense relief, and it's a de-stress. Seriously, reading is a de-stressing. Third is to have knowledge, to improve vocabulary, and to be fluent in English. Like the dictionary part, the amount of words we learn from reading, it just increases with every single page we read, right? And about knowledge, we might not get so much knowledge about facts from fiction, but fictions have a severely different impact on us. Like there are characters whose personality affect us, whose action inspire us, and the story of which we become a part or of which we get a connection or something. Like fiction, they don't give you facts about certain wars or politics or anything, but the characters, the story, the plot, the twist, the mystery, the thriller, everything will improve your imagination and lead you in this world. You have ideas about the real world, about the type of people in outer world, about the type of things that can happen to you, about the impact of trauma or everything in your life and how to come out of that. Non-fictions, on the other hand, are known for giving you the factual knowledge, like solid basic knowledge of wars, of politics, of English, of history, everything. And non-fictions may seem boring sometimes, but certain genres in non-fictions are seriously influential and motivational, like self-help books. They are so important for each and every person in today's world. In the year of pandemic, mental health issue was so much on hype, and we readers are fortunate that that thing didn't acquire our brain or that thing didn't affect us because we have our books. I am fortunate that I was with my family at that time, but books also helped me just spend that whole year. After 3 or 4 months in pandemic, we have to opt for ebooks, but then we learned about reading ebooks, right? Next fact about reading is to escape the real world, either good or bad. Why I talked about escaping the good one? Why anyone would want to escape the good one? Let me tell you why. If a kid's upbringing is done in a rich atmosphere, in a pampered atmosphere, and he or she has not known the reality of words, have not known about the type of people they can meet when they step out of their pampered zone. So books help in dealing with that. When you read a book, you don't only know about the hero and his heroism. You get to know about a villain and his evil works. You get to get a justification about why bad people do bad things. And that clarification, that justification don't come with watching a movie, because there's this hero, there's this villain, and the villain die or do the bad thing and just they go off and the hero saves the world and all, everything, and gets the medal. Oh no, books just tell you why hero is hero, why his actions are heroic, and why a bad person is bad person. What made him that? He was not born as a bad person. What situations, what atmosphere brought him to this position, and why he is doing what he is doing, either inferiority complex or either some revenge or either some hatred, jealousy, and everything that bad resides in our heart. You and I and everyone out there is just about a single incident or you being in a single situation that thing triggers in you also. That you can be turned into a bad people also. All that hatred and jealousy can reside in your heart also. But we are fortunate that we are surrounded by all the good things and we have still the chance to be the hero in our life story. Now we have talked about the most important points about why reading is essential and what impact books have on our life and how they make us better person. But I also want to raise one issue here. Being a bookstagrammer and booktuber, sometimes I feel that I am restrained and bounded to post something, to just post a video on every Wednesday, no matter the schedule, the hectic schedule of my life. Being a bookstagrammer, I think I have to review the book Any book I read, and even if I enjoy it or even if I don't enjoy it, I feel bounded. It's not like there's some rules or regulations, but I feel bounded. I feel like it's my work and I have to do that. And then at that certain point, I stop enjoying reading. And that's seriously disloyalty to my books. So I want to tell you all that reading is about fun. Reading is about your choice. Reading is about choosing a book and reading it because you want to. Reading is not like some academics. You have to read because you have to qualify your exam. No, you are not bounded to read. You can always and always DNF a book. Do not finish. You can always and always explore different genres. You can always pick a book no one has ever read. And you can always read a book which is so much hype. It's all about the choice. And books have taught us that simply, that we can choose. We can choose to read. And reading is not something we are bound to do, but this is about we want to do. So being a bookstagrammer and booktuber, I think I become disloyal to my books and reading sometimes, but I try to just ignore that thing and avoid doing that thing. And I sometimes DNF book. I started doing this from this year, and I don't review some books. Either I love them too much that I think I will do an injustice by explaining them in mere few words, or even if I hate a book and I don't review it, because what should I write about that book, right? Well, if we are finishing that video, I think you might want to meet my niece again. So, should we call her?
Hi, I'm back.
You love reading fairy tales, na?
Yes.
And what is your favorite story?
My favorite story is How Myra Made Friends.
How Myra Made Friends. And your favorite princess is?
My favorite princess is Ariel.
Ariel from The Little Mermaid?
Yes.
And she is obsessed with Frozen, Elsa and Anna. I got to hear that Let It Go song every day.
I love that movie of Frozen and I love the song.
Can you sing it for us?
Yes.
Okay, so let's listen to her.
Snow glows white on a mountain, not a footprint to be seen. A king who lies awake and looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling, life is swirling, storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceit, don't fear, don't let them know. When are they know? Let it go. Let it go, can't hold it back anymore. Let it go, let it go. Through the way you slammed the door, I don't care what they're going to say. Let the storm rage on. Go let it bother me anyway.
Yay! Very good, Misty. Okay, so let's say bye and done with this video, and we will meet you next week. She might leave for Lucknow by then.
Yeah.
Okay.